Let's say we have the vector a, and we know its x and y components. So I'll write it first as a column vector. Its x component is negative 10, and its y component is positive 7. And there's many ways, as we've already seen, to represent a vector. We could also represent it as in unit vector form. So we could write it as negative 10 times the unit vector in the horizontal direction, plus 7 times the unit vector in the vertical direction. But either way, we could draw this thing. We could pick a place, an initial point. And if we say the initial point is the origin, we might as well pick the origin, what would this vector look like? Well, the x component is negative 10, so it would go to negative 10. And then the y component is 7. So we'd go 10 to the left and then 7 up. So 7 up would get us to right over there. And the vector would look like this. So it would start at the origin. And it would end, its initial point would be the origin, and its terminal point would be at x equals negative 10 and y equals 7. So this is one way to represent the vector a. But let's say we wanted to move it around. We wanted it to have a different terminal point. And let's say we were told instead of having the terminal point negative 10, 7, let's say instead it had the terminal point, 3, comma 5. So 3 comma 5, actually let's make this negative 3. Negative 3 comma 5, let's say it had that as its terminal point. So we can imagine what the vector would look like there. We would just translate this vector over, so it would look something like this. It would have the tip of the vector, it would terminate right over there. And then it would start, I don't know, someplace in this area right over here, but I don't know exactly precisely. If I could just copy and paste this and translate it over, I could figure it out on the graph. But instead of doing that, let's see if we can figure it out mathematically. What would be the initial point of the vector, of this vector, of vector A, if the terminal point is negative 3, if the terminal point is negative 3, comma 5? So let's say that the initial point, I, is equal to x initial, comma y. Initial. So y, x sub I, that's x initial, might as well, and y initial. So let's say that's it. So how do we go from having a terminal point or an initial point and a terminal point to actually getting the components of the vector? Well, the x component of the vector is going to be your change in x going from the initial to the terminal point, and your y component is going to be your change in y going from your initial point to your terminal point. So we could have, negative 10, your x component is going to be your change in x going from your initial to your terminal. So that's going to be your terminal x. That's going to be your terminal x, negative 3, minus your initial x, minus x sub I. And then we can do the same thing for the y component. The y component is going to be equal to your change in y. So it's going to be your terminal y. It's going to be 5 minus your initial y. Minus your initial y. And then from this, we can just solve for x sub I, your initial x, and your initial y. So let's see how we could do this. If we multiplied both sides of this times negative 1, we're going to have 10 is equal to xi plus 3. And then if we subtract 3 from both sides, we're going to get xi is equal to 7, or x sub I should say. We're going to get, and I'll do this all in green now, x sub i is equal to 7. And let's do the same thing over here. If we multiplied both sides of this times negative 1, we're going to have negative 7 is equal to y sub I, or our initial y minus 5. Minus 5, add 5 to both sides, you get our initial y is equal to negative 2. So our initial point for our vector, if our terminal point is going to be negative 3, 5, based on the components of the vector, I have a little bit of a cold, so my voice is coming out a little bit funny, I think. So our initial point is going to be the point 7, comma negative 2. And let's see if that makes visual sense. So this is x equals 7, negative 2. So we're saying that is our initial point. So our vector is going to look like, this. which makes a lot of sense. It's just the original vector we had when we had the initial point at the origin, but we've just shifted it over. We've shifted it down 2, and we've shifted it to the right 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you see that right over here. So hopefully now we're pretty well equipped. If we know the initial and terminal point of a vector, we can figure out its x and y components. Or if we know the terminal points and the x and y components, we can figure out the initial point. Or if we know the initial point and we know the x and y components, we can figure out the terminal point. So if we know 2 out of these 3, we can figure out the third piece of information.